Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to check my pooly nail and see how poorly or ill it still or is not.
Is or is not.
Let's find out. So, those of you that would have seen the video that I did where I did like a reconstruction makeover of my nail that was really poorly. These are the nails that I had on. I've had them on for a couple of weeks. I have absolutely trashed these nails. I went camping. And
oh, what happened to that one?
This one's got a crack all the way through it. But it's still holding on. I filed off the design because I want to just check everything. The other ones, you see these little bits here? I'm going like that. So bad. I'm like the worst client. If I was your client,
you would be fair.
Yeah, I would be fair. And then while we were sat looking at some edits, I might slightly knackered that one. And then I've just filed it a little bit. I'm just such a bad nail tech. I really am. So, under this one is the reconstruction that we did, just so I could have a nail on. However, I have since split this nail. I've split it. Can you see there? And then last night, whilst at football training, I did have a little bit of a peck. These are all the things that you shouldn't do. But I'm very, very interested to know what's going on underneath. So we did a clear overlay. We built out in clear acrylic so we could see what's going on underneath, because I want to help you if this happens to you, and I want to, you know, help myself as well along the way. So I'm going to use my e-file to take off the gel polish. I am going to flip the rotation round. So it's now going backwards, which means bit is turning away from me. Wow. It's still absolutely not. It's only been 2 weeks. This is going to take a fair few months to, I'd say 2 or 3 months before it grows up. But I want to look at it. I want to make sure I haven't got a infection in there. I am slightly suspicious that I could have psoriasis. You know?
Oh, really?
Because the end of my fingers are peeling now and then. They keep peeling a bit. I'm not a doctor, so I can't diagnose anything. And neither is Adam.
But I am a psoriasis sufferer.
You are a psoriasis sufferer, yeah, but you can get it in your nails. And I've always said, I've said this to you before, haven't I? I'm surprised that you don't have it in your nails, but it can affect just your nails.
Right.
And it can affect your skin. And you get it only on certain parts of your body, don't you, as well? Mm. So, you know, it is.
There is a girl, I think I Instagram, see a psoriasis. And she always has false nails on.
Mm.
And I wonder if that's why, because she has it.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, I have damaged this nail through football training and that. So, I have knocked it. And I did knock it quite a few times at camping. So, and obviously it's already weak because it's got like a quarter of it missing. So we can see it's still growing up. So let me just buff it so we can get it a little bit smoother. And obviously I'm going to have to repair the break. But imagine if I just kept living with the break. If you can see, let me just dust off. You can see the break there. The break is exactly where that nail finishes. If I left this break on, it could potentially break my nail, this good section of the nail, and then I'd have half a nail, not three quarters. So it's important to whatever you, if you know, if you even go to a salon and you have your nails done and you get a split, make sure you get your ass right back to the salon and get it fixed. Don't just apply glue and start messing about with it yourself. Some people go on holiday and they take all their beauty products and they take a little bit of nail glue because they think, oh well, if it breaks I can just stick it back on, or I can repair it with a bit of nail glue. However, it's probably one of the worst things that you can do, because on holiday your hands are wet, you're in and out the pool, you could glue it and encase moisture underneath your nail. So you've got to think about that. What I want to do now is, so we want to clean it up and have a little look at what is going on under there. I'm going to clean over with acetone because I want to melt the top surface so I can see through the clear a little bit better. So you can kind of see the growth. If you look at my other nails, that's 2 week growth. So we've got a 2 week growth. So it's not grown massively, so I'm not expecting this to be repaired in 2 weeks. But I do need to check if we are still reattaching. And at the minute, I can't see that we are reattaching at all. But I want to make sure that I have no moisture underneath. It doesn't look like we've got any moisture underneath. However, what I'm going to do now is take off this part, or pretty much all of it, all this free edge, and have a little look at what's going on my actual skin of my nail bed and see what that's like a little bit closer. If this was a client, I would definitely want to take that off and just have another look at everything. So I'm going to e-file the majority of it off. Don't forget, I'm using my left hand here. So all I'm doing is thinning out the product. Thinning out the acrylic will make it much easier to remove. Less stress will be on the nail. At the moment, I'm not really pressing on hard at all. I am going to cut this side, so we're going to cut from the good side, cut that away. It's easier to cut now I've thinned it out. We can cut this part that's not stuck. So remember I told you that this product that was there would come off the skin. But that was something that you needed to keep an eye on as well, because you don't want to encase moisture down here. And it doesn't actually look soggy. Yeah, I've seen nails like this before where they've been really soggy here, and you can see that they've, you know, held a lot of moisture, and that's when you start to get, you know, infections and bacteria going a bit crazy in there. So, you know, so far so good. Yeah, I've tried my best to look after it. So let's just neaten this up a little bit. Right, I'm going to soak the rest of it off. So I'm going to get a little bit of foil. I can tear my lint-free pad. I don't need loads of that. I'm going to saturate that in acetone. Pop that over. Wrap him up. And put him in the oven. Joke. So we're going to leave that on for about 5 minutes at first. Sort of 5 to 7 minutes, then we will have a little check. Right, let's have a little look at it so far. What I'm going to do is use that pad to sort of drag off any of the dissolved acrylic. Oh, I think we're nearly off. Yeah, there's hardly anything on that. Wow, that was quick. Just going to quickly go over that. It's not looking great. Let's get rid of that bit there. Just going to file that bit straight. There. Just making sure there's no acrylic underneath that free edge there. So we've got this is a little bit of nail bed that's dry. I'm going to cut off anything that's sort of that can be snagged or I could catch or pull off. And because I don't want to catch it. So I'm just going to use some tiny scissors just to cut that off. It's all dead. It's all white. So we know it's not living. I'm going to cut some of that nail away that's not attached.
Isn't that the bit that's grown, though?
It is the bit that's grown, but I need it to attach. And if there's too much free edge, it'll be more leverage to pull it off the nail bed. So you want to cut that down. I want to make sure that there's no acrylic stuck underneath. So I'm just going to go round with that cuticle knife and just make sure there's nothing stuck underneath, because that will interfere as well. Yeah, see how it's a bit peely? You can see where it's been peeling a little bit.
Yeah.
So it's grown a little bit, but I just need to keep looking after it, I think. And hope that it's going to reattach. So that flakiness that was there that wasn't attached is part of your hypernickium. And because that wasn't attached, that bit there, that was here, then this nail won't attach. So all the layers need to be attached and we need to encourage that. So what I'm gonna do now is just clean this up again, and then I'm going to actually this time just take the acrylic right to the end. I'm not gonna extend out because I don't want to put any more stress on it, because I think if I keep having any kind of length, it's going to keep putting pressure on it and it's going to keep teasing it off that nail bed. I want it to act more like a bandage. So let's give this a clean. We're going to use the gel residue wipe off solution to give it a nice clean. Doesn't feel sore or anything like that. Right, so we're going to prime and dehydrate. So let's get the dehydrator on. I want to make sure I dehydrate even this part. I want to make sure there are no germs in there. So right into that little bit as well. And then we're going to use the Ultra Bond primer just on my natural nail. Don't want to put the primer on this part here. There's no need. I'm going to use natural this time. So, going with one bead. God, I'm using my left hand. It feels so weird. Get the cuticle nice and neat. And I can bring that down. You could use clear. I could use clear again, but I'm not going to put anything on top of this. But I can still, I'm still going to be able to see through it enough to actually see what's going on. That makes sense. So it's not completely opaque. It's only semi-opaque. I'm just going to let that set a little bit, then we'll file it. I'm going to file that quite short, sort of like that. Right, so let's get the sidewall straight. I'm literally going to come round and do more of an overly round nail, sort of squoval, I suppose. So I'm going to work my cuticle area. And then I can thin this out. It is pretty bulky. That always tends to happen when I'm doing my own nails. I feel a bit crazy with the product. So I've got a 240 grit file now, just to refine the shape, making sure I haven't got, like, basically when you turn the hand over, you don't want to see the nail popping over the other side. So I know that acrylic is just there to stop me from catching those edges. I don't want to catch those edges and make it worse. So it's kind of acting like a bandage. Or a band-aid, or plaster, whatever you want to call them. And you see, I was saying, like, you've got that transparency. So I've got a bit of transparency there. So I can still see what's going on underneath. But it also kind of masks it, so it doesn't look overly ugly. And what I could do, I mean, I could put some gel polish over that. Could easily take the gel polish off to have a look what's going on underneath. But that's as long as I want to go. So pretty much no length. Just filling in that gap. Also adding support here. Those of you might be thinking, well, couldn't you just fill that section there and not put the acrylic all the way up here? It wouldn't give the support that's needed. The acrylic that's on the rest of the nail supports the acrylic that is filling in that gap. If you just put it in that section, then what will happen is you're going to put stress on the rest of the healthy nail, and you don't want to do that because we're trying to repair this and look after it. Now, because I don't want to draw attention to that nail, I am not going to put no top coat on or anything like that. I'm just going to leave it bare. I am going to put cuticle oil on, and I'm going to use the tea tree cuticle oil because I know it's going to keep everything nice and clean. I'm going to make sure I rub that into the very tip of my nail, of my finger, sorry, because obviously it's been very dry there. So as much as you want to keep the moisture out, you want to keep moisture from water out and detergents out, the oil will actually help. It looks a little bit better already. I think we should have a bi-weekly check, or at least once a month check.
You ever seen those time-lapse videos where like people leave something for a month?
Yeah.
Just fancy staying there for a month and we'll just time-lapse it.
No, we're not doing that. But we can keep checking on it, because I'm sure everybody's interested to see how I'm getting on with my...
Gammy hand?
Yeah. I mean, it doesn't look as obscene now. It doesn't look disgusting. My other nails look a bit crazy, but what I'll do with my other nail is I'll repair this little crack and I'll take down the length and then I'll just leave them sort of bare for now, just so everything can grow up a little bit. So there you are. Hope you've enjoyed a little part of the journey of Kirsty's pooly nail. It's a bit poorly. It's a bit ill. It's a bit ill. So yeah, we'll catch you next time to check on. It needs a name.
Gone completely.
It needs a name. Comment below for the sick finger nail.
Video.
Yeah, comment below and we'll name the really sad and sick finger of mine. There you are. See you next time. Bye-bye. There's no way that you can do just basically. I'm telling you.